Hundreds of thousands of people are tonight in despair. Their jobs, livelihoods obliterated under extreme new rules. Almost every sector has been hit, including, once again, our travel industry. Today, Virgin Australia's turn to reveal its dire future.
Virgin grounded. 8,000 people now out of work.
It is what it is, darling. It is what it is. We're all in this together. There's nothing we can do.
The cure to this virus is waging war on our jobs, and it's brutal.
We feel, very, very sad.
Flights have been cancelled en masse. Tiger is suspended completely. Many Virgin workers forced to take leave without pay up until the end of May, but likely longer.
Having more people on the ground than we do in the skies is not in the DNA of Virgin Australia.
The terminations flooded through all day. More than 8,000 staff have been stood down at star casinos in Sydney, Brisbane and the Gold Coast because they can't open. Noni B, Rivers, Cadies shut almost 1,400 stores, 7,000 people gone. Sportscraft, Jag and Saba closing 300 shops, and Forever New has shut down too.
These are very difficult changes that we're asking Australians to make. We are very mindful of the impact.
Beauticians like Kristen Fisher joined the bloodbath. Her business now banned from operating.
Dealing with customers, that's the only way we can make money. So with that being banned, there's no money.
Kristen helped raise $250,000 for the bushfires. Her husband runs a gym, both now out of work.
We're all just constantly, every single day, trying to, you know, be more successful and do this and do that. You just have to really remember that your health is first and foremost, and that's all that matters in a time like this.
Retailers are bleeding.
What we're going to see is retailers start to run out of money very, very soon.
One big retailer told Nine News it makes little sense for the government to keep shopping centres open but tell people to stay home because they still have staff, rents and no customers.
They will just close up, go and never to be returned.
The more we are forced to stay apart, the longer these lines will get.
I got down here at about 5 o'clock this morning because I drove past yesterday and I saw the queue was all the way down the street and around the corner.
Centrelink is being overwhelmed.
Third time I've come. Previous 2 days, I've got kids at home, so I couldn't queue up for 2 or 3 hours.
The good news is the MyGov website is coping much better today, and there's a new button which says intent to claim. If you click that, we're told it'll make it a lot easier.
We will then contact you to steer you through the process. So there's no need to queue and there's no need to call us to get your claim started.
There are deep concerns the stress of unemployment could kill more people than the virus itself. The lucky country, certainly not feeling that way right now.
I work in hospitality and I no longer have a job anymore. I've got a wife and just 6 hunting to feed.
Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.